Hello and welcome to Red Stapler channel. In this video, we will show you the collection of 10 stunning web design ideas in 2019 that you should see, and details about technique and library they use. Ready? Let's check it out. This one used 3JS WebGL library and combined it with custom shader. The text and noise images were used to create texture map on plane surface before shader processing. Writing a game might sound complicated, but actually this one is only just a sophisticated checkbox put together with conditions. SCSS and HTML were used to help creating logics. This one is a clever implementation of SVG radial gradient mask. The modify image with sketch effect were put in place and add JavaScript code to mask over with the original image on mouse click. This cool effect is achieved by carefully placed div and a simple transform animation. Box shadow we used to create 3D light effect. SCSS was used to calculate the transform amount and apply to each div. An awesome slider using SVG image. All animations were added by JavaScript using TwinMax, which is part of GSAP or GreenSock animation platform. Actually, this one was created with almost pure CSS using 3D transform and grid template. The JavaScript was added to just enable the scroll feature. I really love this one. The 3D text was created using text geometry and all cardboard textures were embedded into the JavaScript code using Base64 encoding. TwinMax again was used to move the camera when typing new letters. As for physics engine, an open source library Canon.js was used. This is pure CSS animation. It looks like we have a sphere shape, but actually it's just a circle div with box shadow and moving face to create an illusion of spinning. Again, this one is pure CSS. At first, I was certain that this was made with 3JS, but actually it was made with lots of simple square divs, box shadow, CSS animation, and 3D transform. A good design for a product showcase. A transparent product pictures were added to page with CSS hover property to create hover effect. The grid was generated with JavaScript, which automatically recalculate when resizing browser window. No extra library was used. And that's all for this video. You can find all links to the code at the description box below. Hope you guys enjoy, and if you want to see more development tips and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe our channel for weekly update. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye!